Enjoy the next video.
Okay, can I read the text?
Yes. Okay. On the one hand, I don't think that school children should have mobile phones at school. It's too easy for them to get distracted on social media.
Media. Social media.
Social media. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, they are a useful way for kids to get in touch with their parents when there is a crisis.
Crisis.
Be that as it may, is it still a new sense? When phones when phones go off in the middle of a lesson. To put it in a nutshell, there are a lot of pros and cons with regard to kids and mobiles.
Okay, so we have with regard to. Do you remember? We are reviewing. Okay.
Okay.
So with regard to, do you remember?
With regalos, no? Era.
No, regalo no.
Regal.
No, with regard to, con respecto a.
Ah, eso, con respecto a.
Okay. Be that as it may. Do you remember?
No, I don't study in the last
lesson. Don't worry. Sea como fuere. De cualquier manera. Be that as it may. Be that as it may. Okay, in a nutshell, do you remember?
In resumen.
Or we also say, to put it in a nutshell. And these two are very useful. On the one hand, blah, 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 blah. On the other hand, blah, 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 blah. Okay, another expression. To get in touch with. Do you remember?
Get in touch, ponerse en contacto.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Go off. When you talk about a mobile, a phone, or an alarm. What does it mean?
Que sonar era, ¿no?
Sonar, exactly. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay, these are. Okay, we're gonna also review this. This is important. Okay, we're gonna practice. Okay, so here we have six situations. And on the right we have sentences describing the situation. For example, what shall we do? We could go to the zoo. So, she suggested going to the zoo. Ella sugirió ir al zoológico. She suggested going to the zoo. Okay, number two.
Do you want to play tennis? No, not really. He didn't fancy wanting to play tennis.
He didn't fancy playing tennis.
Playing tennis.
What does it mean? ¿Qué significa? He didn't fancy playing tennis.
Fancy era.
Apetecer.
No me apetece jugar al tenis.
No, pasado.
No le apeteció.
No le apeteció. Mm-hmm. Good. Okay, three.
Let's go for a walk. Good idea. Mm-hmm. She suggested. Going for a walk.
Yes. She suggested going for a walk. What does it mean?
Ella preguntó si...
No, preguntó no. Sugirió.
Ir a andar.
O dar un paseo. Ok. Uh-huh. Four.
You caused. Uh-huh. You caused the accident. No, I didn't. He denied.
Uh-huh.
causing the accident.
He denied causing the accident. What does it mean?
Él negó causar el accidente.
Perfect. Fine.
Can you wait a few minutes?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. No problem.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't mind. Waiting a few minutes.
Mm-hmm. What does it mean?
Ellos
mm-hmm.
No tenían en mente.
No les importaba.
No les importaba esperar unos minutos.
Mm-hmm. All right, six.
You didn't tell the trap.
Truth.
That's right. I didn't. She admitted. Not telling the truth.
Yes, she admitted not telling the truth. What does it mean?
Y admitió no decir la verdad.
Admitió no haber dicho lo pasado.
Eso.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, first we're gonna do this. Okay, so now we have to put the words in the right order. The words are between brackets here. So for example, did she really say that? ¿De verdad dijo eso? I don't remember her saying that. No recuerdo que ella dijera eso. I don't remember her saying that. Okay, number two.
It's okay if you want to drive my car.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind it. You driving it.
I don't mind you driving it. What does it mean?
No me importa que lo conduzcas.
Perfect. Three.
What a stupid thing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Can you imagine anybody being so stupid?
Okay, what does it mean?
¿Puedes tú imaginar algo tan estúpido?
No algo. A alguien.
Alguien.
¿Te puedes imaginar a alguien siendo tan estúpido? Mm-hmm. Can you imagine anybody being so stupid? Mm-hmm. Or
we can't control the weather. We can't eat. Raining stop or stop raining it.
We can't stop it raining. We can't stop it raining. What does it mean? We can't stop it raining.
Nosotros
no podemos.
No podemos parar de.
Okay, no podemos hacerlo parar de llover. Refiriéndose al tiempo, ¿sí? We can't stop it raining. Mm-hmm. Five.
I'll be as quiet as a...
Quick.
Mm-hmm. I'll be as quick as I can.
I'll be as quick as I can.
¿Qué significa? Yo seré.
Seré lo más rápido que pueda. I'll be as quick as I can.
I don't want you kid to wait it. I don't want to keep you waiting.
I don't want to keep you waiting. What does it mean?
yo no quiero. Estar mantenerme esperándote.
Hacerte esperar. No quiero hacerte esperar. I don't want to keep you waiting. I don't want to keep you waiting. I don't want to keep you waiting. Vale. Entonces, fíjate que se cumple la regla del ING, incluso si le meto a alguien en el medio. ¿Vale? Detrás de mine, detrás de imagine, detrás de store, detrás de keep, ING. Aunque tengo el you, tengo el anybody en el medio, el lead, sigo manteniendo la regla. Ok. Let's review. Let's see if you remember. He tried to avoid answering my question. Intentó evitar contestar a mi pregunta. Remember, W is silent. We don't say answering, but answering. Answering. Okay, number two.
I'm trying to concentrate. Please stop making so much noise.
What does it mean?
Por favor, para de hacer tanto ruido.
Number three.
I enjoy listening to music. To music.
Okay, listening.
¿No?
La T muda. T silent, okay? Enjoy listening to music. What does it mean?
Yo disfruto escuchando música.
Perfect. Notice in English we always say listen to. Okay? So listen to me, listen to music, listen to someone. Yeah? Four.
I consider it.
No, not considered. Considered. Three syllable. Okay? I considered.
I consider. Consider paying for the job.
Applying.
Eso.
So applying for, okay.
But in the end, I decide
against it. Okay. Do you remember against? Against? Do you know?
En contra, ¿no?
En contra. O que no. En este caso tiene más sentido que no. So, what does it mean? Number four. So, consideré.
Yo consideré. Apuntarme al trabajo.
Solicitar.
Solicitar.
¿Vale? Solicitar el trabajo.
Pero al final yo decidí que no.
Exactly. Ok. Apply for. So, yo puedo decir apply for a job, solicitar un trabajo. ¿Qué más puedo solicitar? I can say apply for.
Buscar, look for, ¿no?
No, solicitar. So, for example, you can apply for a credit card. Yeah? Or you can apply for a mortgage. Yeah? Or you can apply for a scholarship, una beca. Okay. Number five.
Okay. Have you finished reading the newspaper yet?
Have you finished reading the newspaper yet?
Finalizado de leer ya el periódico.
Exacto. Vale, recuerda que la Y se pronuncia como una I, no es ye, es ye, yet. ¿Vale? Yet. Vale, yet. ¿Se recuerda? Tiene dos sentidos. En pregunta es ya, en negativa es todavía. For example, I haven't finished yet. No he terminado todavía. Number six.
We need to change our
routine.
Routine. We can go on.
We can't go on.
Living.
We can't go on living like this. So go on, you remember?
Yo no puedo seguir viviendo.
No, no podemos seguir. Go on, continuar, seguir. So you can say carry on or go on. Carry on. Go on. Continúa. Carry on. Go on. Ok, go on. Tiene otro sentido. Te enseño una frase que va a escuchar mucho en películas. What's going on? What's going on? ¿Ya has escuchado alguna vez antes? What's going on?
Sí.
¿Qué pasa? ¿Qué está pasando? ¿Qué pasa? Ok. What's going on? Entonces, go on tiene dos sentidos. Two meanings. Ok. Continue. For example, go on. Go on.
Sorry, Javi. Ok.
So go on has two meanings, continue or happen, yeah? So for example, what's going on?
Can you repeat please, Jorge?
Yes, of course. Go on means happen in the question what's going on. But or go on also means continue, proceed. For example, go on. Sí, tiene dos sentidos, dos significados. Ocurrir o continuar. ¿Ok?
Y esa cuestión, this question, what's going on en continuar.
What's happening? What's happening?
¿Qué sucedió?
¿Qué está pasando? Pero, no, ¿qué sucedió? No es pasado, es presente. Es ahora. What's going on? What is going on now? ¿Ya?
Yeah? Vale.
Pero yo digo, por ejemplo, go on working, but go on talking. O te digo solamente, go on, don't stop, go on, continue, ¿ya? Yeah?
Vale, pero con el what, aparte de que está pasando, cuando dices de continuar, ¿cómo es, qué significaría? El otro significado.
A ver, quiero una frase con continuar. A ver, por ejemplo. She went on...
What's going on solo significa que está pasando.
Sí.
Vale, vale.
Sí. Vale. El contexto es lo que te va a decir qué significa go on. ¿Vale? Si me estás refiriendo a suceder, o continuar. Por ejemplo, si yo te digo esto. She went on talking. ¿Qué significaría aquí?
Ella estuvo caminando.
Ella continuó hablando. Ella continuó. ¿Ya? Entonces, normalmente, cuando yo pongo un verbo ing, especialmente cuando pongo un verbo ing, significa continue. ¿Ya? Anyway, 7.
Is it better to avoid? What does avoid mean? I don't remember.
Evitar.
Evitar. Traveling during the rush hour.
Yes. It's better to avoid traveling during the rush hour. What does it mean?
Es mejor evitar viajar durante la punta.
La hora punta. Okay. 8.
My memory is getting worse. I keep
forgetting things. My memory is getting worse. What does it mean?
Mi memoria está perdiendo.
Está empeorando. Está empeorando. I keep forgetting things.
Estoy olvidando cosas. O...
Vale, keep. Vale, keep es. Vale. Keep es una palabra un poco difícil de traducir. Pues significa varias cosas. Vale, keep puede ser guardar, por ejemplo. Si te digo, I would like to keep my books. Mantener también. Pero también significa hacer algo de forma repetida. Siempre. So I keep forgetting things. Lo puedo traducir como siempre se me olvidan las cosas. ¿Vale? I keep forgetting things. Siempre se me olvidan las cosas. ¿Sí? Okay. Nine.
I put off. I put off. Paying.
Yes.
This bill so many times. I really must do it today.
Reúnelo. No se pare. No do it. Do it. Do it.
I really must do it today.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Put off. Do you remember?
Pagar.
Pagar no. Pagar es pay. Posponer. Aplazar. Okay. Put off. So I've put off paying this bill so many times. What does it mean?
Yo he aplazado esta factura mucho tiempo.
Muchas veces, no tiempo, veces.
Muchas veces. Yo debo, yo realmente, ¿no? Debo pagarlo.
Sí, tengo que hacerlo hoy. Solo he aplazado pagar esta factura muchas veces. Lo tengo que hacer hoy, ¿no? Debo hacerlo hoy. Vale, el really en inglés es para poner énfasis. No hace falta que siempre lo traduzca en español. Ten. I given up, bla bla bla, to learn Japanese. I was making no progress.
Trying.
I'm giving up trying to learn Japanese. I was making no progress. Mm-hmm.
Yo he dejado de intentar aprender japonés. No estaba progresando.
Exacto.
Yo.
Eleven.
If you gamble, you risk losing your money.
Losing your money. If you gamble, ¿qué era gamble? ¿Recuerda?
Gamble.
Vale, recuerda, gamble relaciona con casino, con Las Vegas, ¿vale? Todo lo que se hace en Las Vegas es gamble. Ruleta, lotería, dado, cartas, la máquina de traper, todo eso es gamble. ¿Vale? So, jugar con dinero. O jugar juegos de azar. So, if you gamble, si juegas con dinero,
tú tienes riesgo de perder tu dinero.
Exacto. Te arriesgas a perder tu dinero. Uh-huh. So, risk, arriesgar. And 12.
Would you mind not interrupting me all the time? Let me speak.
Mm-hmm. Would you mind not interrupting me all the time? Let me speak. What does it mean?
Importaría no interrumpirme todo el tiempo. Déjame hablar.
Perfect. Okay. Okay. So, we have seen for some verbs you need ing. So you say mind doing, risk doing, enjoy doing, yes, for example. For some of the verbs you need the infinitive with to. For example, we say offer to do, agree to do, hope to do, promise to do. Okay, we're gonna go through these verbs. Okay, so do you know offer?
Ofertar, ofrecer,
incluso oferta. Agree?
Acordar.
Ok, acordar, estar de acuerdo, ponerse de acuerdo. Uh-huh. Refuse.
Rehusar.
Rehusar. Decide.
Decidir.
Decidir. Plan, easy. Arrange.
Arrange. Alcanzar, puede ser.
Organizar. Organizar. Hope.
Esperar.
Claro. Esperar de esperanza, ¿vale?
Sí.
Recuerda que en inglés tenemos tres esperas. Tenemos wait for someone, hope and expect. Forget.
Olvidar.
Manage.
También puede ser organizar o manejar.
No, manage es apañarse o conseguir. ¿Vale? Conseguir. Fail. Fail.
Fallar.
Fallar, fracasar, no conseguir. Promise.
Prometer.
Threaten. Threaten.
Threaten.
Threaten.
I don't know. I don't know.
Amenazar.
Amenazar.
Okay. Deserve. Deserve.
Deserve. Anular la reserva o algo.
No. Merecer. Merecer.
¿Y anular una reserva?
Cancel. Cancel reservation. Afford?
Afford. I don't remember. Afford.
Vale. Poderse pagar. Permitirse algo económicamente. Por ejemplo, poderse pagar. Tener dinero para hacer algo. Let me give you an example. Can you afford to buy a Ferrari? Yeah? You understand?
Can you repeat, please? For...
Sure. Let me type it. Can you afford to buy a Ferrari?
¿Puedes permitirte comprarte un Ferrari?
Okay. Learn.
Aprender.
And then. Tener tendencia.
Okay,
let's read these sentences. Can you read this one here?
It was a long way to walk, so we decided to take a taxi home.
Okay, next one.
Simon was in a difficult situation.
Simon.
Simon was in a difficult situation, so I agreed to help him.
To help him. Okay, next one.
I don't understand.
Let me show you. To wave.
Ayuda.
Con la mano. Hacer sin con la mano. To wave. Yeah, here you are. So I wave to Karen.
But fail.
Fail.
But fail to attract her attention.
Okay, next one.
I like Dan, but I think he tends to call to talk to too much.
Talk. Next one.
How old were you when you learned to drive?
I was 18. Okay. Okay. También se puede negar poniendo not, ¿vale? For example, can you read this?
We decided not to go out because of the weather.
Vale. Because of, por culpa de, debido a, ¿vale? Because of. No lo confundo con because, que es porque. Because of, debido a, por culpa de, ¿ya? So we decided not to go out because of the weather. Decidimos no salir por el tiempo. Por culpa del tiempo. Next one.
I promise.
Promise.
I promise not to be late.
Okay. Vale. Ok. Vale, la misma regla se aplica para estos verbos aquí. Vale, tenemos seem, parecer, appear, básicamente lo mismo.
Seem, what does mean seem?
Parecer.
Parecer. ¿Y appear?
Lo mismo. Ok, pretend, fingir. Claim, proclamar.
¿Claim has dicho?
Proclamar.
¿Y no reclamar?
No reclamar. Proclamar. ¿Reclamar?
Complain, ¿no?
Complain. Practice this. Okay, so here we have six different situations. So, shall we get married? ¿Nos casamos? Yes, let's. Sí, vamos. So, they decided to get married. Decidieron casarse. They decided to get married. Okay, number two.
Please help me. Okay. She agreed.
Agreed. Mm-hmm.
Agreed to help me.
Him. Él. Oh. She agreed to help him. Okay, number three.
Can I carry your bag for you? No thanks, I can manage.
Mm-hmm.
He offered to carry my bag.
Her bag, you mean? Her bag. La de ella, ¿no? 4. Let's meet at 8:00. Okay, fine.
They are arranged to meet at 8:00.
Yes.
Then.
At 8:00. Mm-hmm. Okay. Fine.
One moment, Javi, please.
Okay.
Sorry.
Don't worry.
What's your name? I'm going to tell you.
I'm not gonna tell you.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
She refused. Refused.
Mm-hmm.
He refused.
Ah, ella se negó a decirle su nombre.
She refused. To tell him.
Mm-hmm.
Tell him her name.
Yes, perfect. 6. Please don't tell anyone. I won't, I promise.
He promised.
Mm-hmm.
To tell. She promised.
Okay. Him. She says, I won't. No, not about it.
She promised not telling.
Okay, not to.
Not to telling.
To tell Ariel?
She promised not to tell
Her
Anyone.
She promised not to tell anyone. Okay. They decided to get married. What does it mean?
Ellos decidieron casarse.
Mm-hmm. She agreed to help him. What does it mean?
Ella acordó ayudarle.
Mm-hmm. He offered to carry her bag.
Él se ofreció a llevarle su maleta.
Mm-hmm. O bolsa, diría yo. Bolsa. They arranged to meet at 8 o'clock.
Ellos organizaron quedar a las 8.
Vale. En español puede decir, ellos quedaron a las 8, ya está. O sea, organizaron para encontrarse, literalmente. Quedar, diríamos en español. Uh-huh. She refused to tell him her name.
Ella rehusó decirle su nombre.
Uh-huh. She promised not to tell anyone.
Ella prometió no decir nada.
No contárselo a nadie. Uh-huh. Okay, do you understand this? I can manage.
Vale. Yo puedo apañarme.
Yo me apaño. Yo puedo. Puedo hacerlo, ¿vale? Básicamente. Yo consigo. Alright. Now it's gonna be a little bit difficult. Because now we have two groups mixed. Ahora tenemos verbo de los dos capítulos. De los que necesitan tú y de los que necesitan ING. Let's see if you manage to do this. Okay. For example, number one. When I'm tired, I enjoy watching TV. Entonces decimos enjoy ING, ¿no? I enjoy watching TV. It's relaxing.
Uh-huh.
Estoy cansado. Disfruto viendo la tele. Es relajante. Okay, number two. The verb is here then.
Mm-hmm. I decided to look for another job, I need a change.
Perfect. Number three.
I'm not going anywhere. I refuse to move.
Perfect. Four.
I'm not in a hurry. I don't mind waiting.
Yes. Five.
Tina ran in a marathon last week.
Marathon. Mm-hmm.
Tina ran in a marathon last week, but she failed to finish.
Six.
I wish that dog would stop barking.
Barking, yes.
She's driving me crazy.
Mm-hmm. Seven.
They didn't know it was listening to
I was listening to them.
I pretended to be asleep.
Yes. Eight.
We were hungry, so I suggested to have dinner early.
Having dinner early. Mm-hmm. Nine.
Hurry up. I don't want to risk.
Okay, not risk. Risk.
Risk.
Mm-hmm.
Missing
the train. And ten.
David is very
quiet.
Mm-hmm. Quiet. He tends not saying much. To say much.
Okay, so now I'm gonna read and you tell me what it means. So let's try with the first one. When I'm tired, I enjoy watching TV. It's relaxing. What does it mean?
Cuando yo estoy cansado, yo disfruto viendo la tele, es relajante.
Mm-hmm. Number two. I've decided to look for another job. I need a change. What does it mean?
Yo he decidido buscar otro trabajo. Necesito un cambio.
Perfect. Wow, you're on fire today. I'm not going anywhere. I refuse to move. What does it mean?
Yo no voy a ningún lado.
Mm-hmm.
Yo he rehusado el
me niego a moverme. Rehuso moverme. Me niego a moverme. No voy a ninguna parte. Mm-hmm. I'm not in a hurry. I don't mind waiting.
Yo no estoy. Hurry. What does that mean, hurry?
Okay. Okay, this is an expression. I'm not in a hurry. No tengo prisa. I'm not in a hurry. ¿Cómo pregunto a alguien si tiene prisa? Si I'm not in a hurry significa no tengo prisa. ¿Cómo pregunto? A ver,
do you?
No, not do you.
Do you?
Tell it to be.
Are you hurry?
Are you in a hurry? Are you in a hurry? Are you in a hurry? Are you in a hurry? ¿Tienes prisa?
Okay.
I'm not in a hurry, I don't mind waiting. What does it mean?
Yo no tengo prisa.
Uh-huh.
No estoy pensando. No me importa esperar.
Perfect. Fine. Tina ran in a marathon last week, but she failed to finish.
Tina corrió el maratón la última semana.
La semana pasada.
Pero ella
no
consiguió acabarlo.
Perfect. Ella no consiguió acabarlo. Perfect. Six. I wish that dog would stop barking. It's driving me crazy.
Yo deseo que ese perro.
Vale. Significa yo deseo, no está mal. Pero normalmente en español lo diría, no diríamos yo deseo, diríamos ojalá. Ojalá.
Ojalá ese perro pare de ladrar, es barking.
Parará de ladrar, eso es. Ojalá ese perro parara de ladrar. Uh-huh. It's driving me crazy. Otra buena expresión.
Me está volviendo loco.
Me está volviendo loco. ¿Cómo diría yo? Mi hijo me está volviendo loco. ¿Cómo digo eso?
My
son, no son, son.
My son is driving me crazy.
My son is driving you crazy. Is your son driving you crazy?
No.
No? Okay.
He's very, very good.
Yeah. He's a very good boy, yes. All right. Seven.
¿Dónde? Ah, seven.
Seven, yes.
Ellos...
Sorry, they didn't know I was listening to me. I pretended to be asleep. Asleep.
Ellos no sabían que yo estaba escuchando música.
Escuchándoles a ellos.
Escuchándoles.
Uh-huh.
Yo pretendía quedarme dormido.
Pretendía, no. Yo fingía.
Ah.
O me hice el dormido.
Yo me hice
para pretender no es pretender. Es fingir. Be careful, okay? It's a false friend. 8. We were hungry, so I suggested having dinner early.
Hungry.
Mm-hmm.
We were hungry. Nosotros teníamos hambre.
Mm-hmm. Así que.
Por eso yo sugerí cenar pronto.
Perfect. 9. Hurry up. I don't want to risk missing the train.
Vamos, Harry era vamos, ¿no?
Date prisa, date prisa.
Date prisa. Yo no quiero perder el tren o arriesgarme a perder el tren.
Exactly. Yo no quiero arriesgarme a perder el tren. Mm-hmm. David is very quiet. He tends not to say much.
David estaba muy callado.
Es muy callado, es muy callado.
Él tiende a no hablar mucho.
Él tiende a no hablar mucho. Oh, no, tengo. Uh-huh. Okay. Okay. We're gonna take a look at some more expressions. Okay, let's start with coming. Okay, coming. Muy, muy útil. Vamos a empezar por Cami. Ha empezado Cami. Cami, primer significado de Cami es entra. Cuando estás en una habitación y alguien está en la puerta. Cami. O cuando hablo de un tren, significa llegar. Pero solo cuando estoy hablando del tren o un medio de transporte, ¿vale? All right. For example, the train just coming in now. Yeah, arriving. Okay, we also have check-in. Vale, este es fácil, ¿no? Check-in.
El check-in.
Sí, el check-in y el check-out, ¿no? Sería el contrario. Okay, look up. Okay, look up también tiene un par de significados. Look up means get better. When you talk, for example, about business or economic, yeah? Business was bad, but now things are looking up. And show up. Show up es como can mean, pero para personas. Llegar a un sitio, ¿no? Aparecer. So, for example, she didn't show up till the next morning. Okay. Okay, we also have look up. También se puede usar con palabras o con información. So, if I say look a word up, me refiero a que lo busque en un diccionario, ¿vale? Look it up. O en internet.
Busca, o sea, look up es buscar, ¿no?
Sí, pero buscar información, no a alguien, ¿vale? Si quieres decir buscar a alguien, ¿recuerdas cómo era? ¿O algo?
El look up and one.
No, el look for.
Look for.
Entonces.
Porque el look up, ese primero que me has dicho que era.
Vale, look at, mirar, ¿vale?
Sí.
Look up significa buscar información o mejorar. ¿Vale? Vamos a hablar de economía, de negocio, ¿vale? Entonces tenemos look at, que mirar, look for, buscar en general, y luego look up, con up, up, tiene dos sentidos, mejorar o buscar información. Ok, make something up. Este también es otro que tiene un montón de sentido. Por el momento solo vamos a ver uno. Inventar. So usually a story or excuse, yeah? So I didn't want to see him, so I made up an excuse. ¿Vale? Se suele usar mucho con excusa o con historia, ¿no? So to make up an excuse. Inventarse una excusa, ¿no? Okay. And we have try on, que probarse ropa. So I tried the jacket on, but it was too small. Este tipo de verbo que viene con una preposición puede a veces tener un objeto, ¿vale? O a veces no lleva objeto. Entonces, cuando no lleva objeto, no se puede poner, por ejemplo, look up, cuando te refieres a mejorar, no tiene nada. Se dice, the economy is looking up. ¿Vale? Pero cuando lleva objeto, se puede poner en el medio, ¿vale? Es posible partirlo así. De hecho, si te acuerdas, se partía cuando se pone el pronombre. Por ejemplo, write down, se dice write it down. ¿Vale? Ok. We're going to take a look at five more expressions. Vale, con look hay otro más. Look after. Cuidar. Look after. Este va siempre junto, ¿eh? No se puede separar. Y el último de look, ¿puedo hoy? Look into. Investigar. For example, I complained to the airline and they are looking into it. Buscar el problema, descubrir el problema, investigar. Okay. This one very, very useful. Come across. Come across es cruzarse, tropezarse con alguien o algo. For example, I came across the word in an article. Or I came across my boss in the street. Yeah? Yeah?
No, me quedan 9 minutos, ya acabó, ¿vale? Te aburres. Ahora acabamos, ¿vale?
Okay. We have stand for. So, for example, what does WWW stand for? So, stand for significa representar o significa. Vale. Go with. Esto es salir con alguien. Y el último de hoy. Cut back on. Bajar la cantidad. Reducir. For example, must cut back on sweets to try and lose weight. Okay. Let's try. Vamos a intentar uno. Y ya terminamos por hoy. So we have 8 sentences and there is a missing word. Okay? In some of the sentences, there's a missing word. It, usually, yeah? Entonces, a alguna frase le falta la palabra it. A otra no. ¿Vale? So you have to tell me if they're right or wrong. If you have the missing it, where it goes. Okay? For example, number one. If you don't know the meaning, look it up in the dictionary. Hay que poner el it en el medio, ¿vale? Look it up. Búscalo en el diccionario. Look it up. Okay, number two. Correct or incorrect?
Correct.
Incorrect.
Looking it.
Looking
it into.
No, no va en el medio. Looking into it. Entonces, fíjate lo que pasa. Algunos de estos verbos se separan. Otros no. Por ejemplo, look into, look after, no se separa. So, looking into it. Además, ¿qué significa looking into? Look into.
Investigar.
Investigar. Okay, number two.
It was a true story.
Story. Story.
Story. I'm sure he just made up.
Okay, correct or incorrect?
Correct.
Incorrect.
I'm sure he just made it up.
Made it up, yes. ¿Qué significa he just made it up?
Él solo.
No. Seguro, estoy seguro que él acaba de.
Just es seguro y solo también, ¿no?
No, aquí significa acaba de. Acaba de. Ya hablaré más en profundidad sobre esta palabra. ¿Qué significa made it up?
Acaba de.
Él acaba de. ¿De qué?
Hacerlo.
Inventárselo.
Inventar.
Recuerda, make up es inventar, no hacer. No confunda make con make up. Son dos cosas diferentes. Number three.
They beat her early, but they didn't show up till 9 o'clock.
Okay, they said they'd be here early and they didn't show up till 9 o'clock. Correct or incorrect?
Correct.
It's correct. Vale, show up, do you remember?
Show up, llegar.
Llegar, aparecer, ¿no?
Sí.
Ellos no aparecieron hasta las 9, ¿no? They didn't show up till 9 o'clock. 4.
Can I ask you about your cap?
Mm-hmm.
Who looks after when you go on holiday?
Correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. So,
look after it.
Look after it, yes. Look after it. ¿Qué significa look after?
Buscar.
No, no buscar. Eso es look for.
Investigar.
No, eso es look into.
Sí. Cuidar.
Sí, te creo que se parece mucho, pero en el momento de cambiar la preposición cambia el significado. Es más, alguno, depende del contexto, puede significar una cosa u otra. 5. I don't know what MP3 stands for. Do you? For ok o not ok? What do you think? Ok o not ok? Correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
It's actually correct. Sorry. Está bien. It's correct. It's correct. ¿Vale? Stand for, do you remember?
Representar.
Representar o significar, ¿no? Yo no sé lo que significa MP3. ¿Tú? ¿Y tú? ¿Do you? Ok, 6. I haven't seen the website before. I came across yesterday on the internet. ¿Correct o incorrect?
Yo no.
Yo no había visto. I haven't seen. La página de internet, website.
Yo entré ayer en internet.
No, entré no. Yo no había visto la página de internet antes.
I don't know.
So, do you think this is correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
It's incorrect. So,
I cannot cross it.
I came across it, yes. ¿Qué significa come across? You remember?
Yo.
No es, no es venir, ¿vale? No es come. Es come across.
Navegué.
Cruzarse. Atravesarse. Tropezarse, ¿vale? So I came across, el pasado, ¿no? I came across it yesterday on the internet. Por cierto, si alguna vez habla con un americano, que sepa que ellos no dicen internet, dice internet.
Internet.
Internet, sí. Le encanta comerse las tres. Por si te habla, por ejemplo, better. ¿Sí? 7. If you try on and it's too big, you could always give it to me. ¿Correcto o incorrecto?
Correct.
Incorrect. So what's the problem?
If you try it on.
Yes, if you try it on. ¿Qué significa try on?
Try on. Probarse.
Probarse ropa, eso es. Si tú lo pruebas y te queda grande, siempre me lo puedes dar. You could always give it to me. ¿Eh? 8. Uh-huh. The train was delayed. Delay, retrasado. The train was delayed, but it finally came in at midday. Okay or not okay?
Came in. Incorrect.
It's actually correct. Came in significa llegar. Cuando hablamos de un tren, por ejemplo. So, el tren se había retrasado, pero al final llegó a mediodía. Midday.
Okay.
Good job. Keep it up. Keep it up.
Okay.
Esta es la última de hoy. Keep it up.
Sigue así.
Siga así.
Okay, perfect.
Perfect. Okay, we'll stop it.